All right, let's go from the birthday cake back to the workplace. And joining us this morning, an expert on workplace issues, we say good morning to Kelly Accetta. Kelly, thank you for joining me in Memphis. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Thank you for having me.
You know, we spend so much time at the workplace that sometimes we will trip up and make a mistake, and sometimes we'll do it on purpose in the form of lies. What's this recent study talking about?
Well, it was really eye-opening of how many white lies employees and employers are saying out there. It is really crazy. The study was done by Simply Hired, and it found that 60% of the 1,000 people responded with "I'm sick" or "I have plans after work" being their most common lies, and it was eye opening. But you know, it's really a respect issue, and it's a respect issue on both sides, for the employer to the employee, but also the employee to the employer. And we have to realize we can't demand respect; we have to earn it. So it was really crazy.
Let's talk a little bit about lies from the employee to the employer. What are some things that, you know, sometimes you just simply run out of personal days off to use, and sometimes there are lies. But what are some other reasons why employees may lie to their employer?
Well, again, this is really all about boundaries. And so if an employer is unfairly asking things of their employees, maybe working through the weekend or, you know, schedules that are just crazy and you can't plan your week, and that wasn't discussed in the very beginning, then, you know, an employee feels justified in doing anything and everything to make sure they get theirs and they get their time off or they get their schedule the way they want it. And it really, like I said, it boils down to respect. If the boss or the company is not respecting an employee's need for consistency or the boundaries that were already preset, it's going to kind of force them into a corner. And it's not just bad people that are lying at work from this study. It's the good employees as well. So it is an incredible story.
It sounds like the lack of, or at least the perceived lack of communication with management, and also feeling like you've gotten the old bait and switch from when you got hired. Sounds like those are two of the biggest reasons why employees feel like that they just can't be shoot straight with their employer.
Absolutely. And one of the examples in this study was a woman who was working for an infamous company with their policies and their strict workplace. And, you know, in that regard, you really can't, you don't have a lot of leg to stand on. If you accept a job and you know that they are just beasts when it comes to their policies and what they expect from you, then unfortunately you have to suffer the repercussions. But if you were hired with one thing, you know, a lot of companies make themselves sound like they're just spectacular and that, you know, working for them is just going to be such a joy. And then you get there and it's not the case. So that's where we need to communicate, and we really need to set real healthy boundaries. And if they won't respect those boundaries, then in this job market, it might be time to move on. Because what the study talked about was, If you're listening to this right now and you find yourself, you're lying, oh, there was traffic, and you're late for work all the time, and you're making excuses and you're saying all these white lies, your job satisfaction is very equally tied to the amount of lies you tell a week. And so if we find ourselves constantly making excuses or constantly lying, we need to look in the mirror and say, you know what, we probably aren't satisfied like we need to be with what we're doing. For that many hours a week, we should be happy and healthy and enjoying what we do to the most extreme possible.
Kelly, thank you so much for joining me on Memphis Morning News. We covered a lot of ground this morning, and it is just a good reminder for some, just maybe a mental gut check of our own situation or wherever we are in our workplace. Kelly Accetta, thank you so much. Please don't be a stranger.
Oh, my pleasure, Tim. Thank you so much for having me.
Sure thing. There's Kelly Accetta on Memphis Morning News. And